Good morning, brothers and sisters.
Good morning.
It is so good to be here with you. Yes, it is true that we survived two Category 5 hurricanes within 12 days. I lived alone in a 4-bedroom house, all the bedrooms and a bathroom upstairs, living room and dining areas downstairs, concrete at the bottom, redwood up top. And you know, when we say hurricane, we know in the Caribbean we get hurricanes. It's just not, we just don't know how severe they're gonna be and how many we're gonna get in a year, a season. And I'm always running, ripping and running, and I thought those were gonna be about 3 days. I could just be quiet in the house and just relax and, you know, curl up, listen to the rain beat on the galvanized rooftop, which is always so soothing. But I also have a cousin who was first cousin to my mom and my aunt, and she lives alone. And I thought, you know, I should go over there. She shouldn't be by herself. Her son is a firefighter, he'll probably be busy. I should go over there. I don't want to go over there. I just want to stay here, I want to relax, I want to just, you know. And so I had a conversation with my sister Doris, and she said, you need to go over there. I said, no, I don't need to go over there. I don't want to go, but I feel like I should go. And she said, no, you need to go. I said, you don't hear me. I don't think I need to go. I certainly don't want to go, but I feel like I should go. And with that, I called my cousin. I said, I'm coming over. We're going to do the hurricane together. And that was about maybe 6 o'clock. She goes to bed like 8:30, unlike my mother, who's up till, you know, 11, 12, 1 o'clock. So it's 10:30 at night, and I'm home. And she said, I thought you weren't coming. I said, I have to cover down things, you know, in case any leaks and so on. And around 9 o'clock that morning, she said, my son is calling from Florida, and he said we need to go downstairs. He's worried that the roof is going to blow off of my house. And I said, okay. So we went downstairs, and hurricanes started coming in. And we went from seeing full, green, healthy trees to sticks within just a few hours. And I took video. I thought I would go outside every hour and take video every for about 20 seconds, and I did that for about 3 hours, and after that I couldn't go outside anymore. And 2 days later, a day and a half later, her son and I decided to walk to my house, about 3 miles. Hadn't done that before. Had a machete in my hand, just in case I had to cut something. Yeah. Going down the street. Serious, on my shoulder. Climbing between down lines, crossing over poles, which were barring the roadways. And as we got closer, he looked at me, he said, Vivi. I said, what do you mean? Well, he said, your house gone. I said, my house gone? He said, look. So it's in a valley, like, and houses all around it. I'm like, I can't see the house. He said, yeah, it's gone. I was like, no, you mean it gone? And he said, you see the yellow house? I said, yeah, that's my neighbor. He said, okay, well, your house is in front of it. I'm looking at it, all my eyes, I can't see. And then I saw a door that goes to my kitchen that's burgundy. And I was like, but where's the other door? And where's the upstairs? And as I got closer, yeah. I couldn't believe what I was saying. The whole top floor was totally gone, spread out in the yard. They say if you're in a hurricane, I don't know about this advice, but that's what they say. If you're in a hurricane and your roof comes off, to get in your bathtub and cover yourself with a mattress. That's what they say. Well, if you want, I can show you the pictures. My bathtub is at the back of my yard, which is like across the street from here. Leaned up on a fence, and my thickest mattress, I like that mattress, it's in my neighbor's yard. So y'all, if I had stayed, oh, and then the downstairs, a lot of the houses have galvanized sheets on the roof. Well, there were 2 sheets of galvanized from down the street that had spun around in my living room. So even if I was downstairs with the concrete walls, there's no way I'd be standing here today. I'd be recovering somewhere, or I wouldn't be here at all. So that still small voice that said to me that you should. You may not want to go sit around, and I love my elders, but you may not want to feel like you're going to be stuck in the house with an elder for 3 days, because you don't want to go. But you should go. I can testify today that that is what saved my life. I left everything just kind of how it was. I was able to retrieve some stuff. My cousin made a ramp so I could go up. They could go up and get some things down. But generally speaking, I kind of walked away and left it as it is. And I'll sort it out whenever I go back, whenever that is, which I haven't even decided when that is. But it's good to be here. It's good to have electricity. Something as simple as ice in your glass. The tinkle of ice. I don't want a plastic cup, I want it in a glass. I laugh today and I make it light, but it's a serious situation down there. They're slowly restoring power to some areas. We're hearing probably December, January before St. Thomas is in lights, and then St. Croix probably further behind. Pray for us there, you know. My work is domestic violence, sexual assault, child abuse, elder abuse, and families have grown bigger than they expected. Where I'm staying, at my mom's cousin, there are 3 different households now in there, where 2 other family members ran for rescue there. So, but we're a pleasant family, and we don't mind being around each other. But there are families that are really falling apart because of this, beyond the devastation of the homes and the streets and whatnot. It's the, you know, you showed up with your 4 children and your 2 suitcases, and you know, in a situation that's really not conducive, and there's still no lights, and the mosquitoes are getting bigger, and there's a curfew till 6 o'clock, and you're on long lines for the bank, and you're long lines for ICE, and you're long lines for provisions, and we're not sure where FEMA is right now, and so the tensions are getting high. So I'm here, and there are a few of us that have been able to get off the island because we have options, thank God, for family. And for love here in Wilmington. So thank you for thinking that it was worth me speaking. And thanks for the love. Zaliyah, to walk in and just have your arms like that welcoming me, I appreciate that. Love you too. Thanks. Amen.